important minerals in the world. Now here we are discussing more about geography and less about chemistry. No doubt this is part of chemistry also. Now first thing that whenever we are saying minerals and we are talking of ore, first important thing we should consider that ore and mineral, what is difference between them? Ore is also a mineral from which one can extract metal on commercial basis. So can I say ore as mineral? Answer is yes. But need not be every mineral we should consider as ore. So every mineral is not necessary ore, but every ore is mineral only. Now forget of that technical part. What is the most important thing? Can we obtain metals in pure form? Answer is yes, but not all the metals. Say for example gold, we can obtain gold in pure form. To some extent copper, that is also obtained in pure form. If meteorite fall is there, then cobalt, nickel or iron, that can be obtained in pure form. Otherwise the metals usually obtained in combined form. Usually metals are obtained in form of their oxides, sulfides, sulfates. Let me clarify, this is part of chemistry and no doubt we have to get differences. So I am writing out formula over here. So whenever, suppose some metal, M is not necessarily a specific metal, I am taking any one compound. If it is combined with S, then we are calling this as sulfide. Whereas if I am saying this is combining with some SO4 group, that is called as sulfate. So here metals usually in form of metallic oxides, formula can be anything, here N and here M, like that. So anything, but it is usually in form of oxides, sulfide, sulfate, then this is called as halides. So usually ore obtained is in this format. Now after obtaining ore, there are several processes. Say that is called as concentration of ore. We can say that is purification of ore. So first thing is concentration of ore, then usually roasting, smelting, calcination, that is the reduction processes, electro refining, like that processes are there and metal is obtained from that. Or not necessarily metal, other components are obtained from that. Say for example, here we can obtain sulfur also on requirement as sulfide is there, but that is considered as byproduct. Now first thing that whenever we are saying that these processes are there, so ores are not obtained, metals, they are not obtained in pure state with few exceptions. Now I am discussing this topic into two parts. One thing worldwide and second thing with special reference to India. Now first we are discussing about aluminium. Now that is metal and nowadays it is used for wide variety of purposes. This is metal having light weight. It is good conductor of electricity and heat. If I am giving rank, what are the common commercial uses, then silver is having very good conductance, second copper, and third level we are placing aluminium. Aluminium can be alloyed. Alloy means mixture of metal. to get desired property for that particular metal or that for particular alloy. What is the important property of aluminium? That is the light weight is important property of aluminium, and that's why it is alloyed with various strong elements to get strength as well as light weight. And that's why aluminium is very, very important. The principal ore of aluminium, that is bauxite. Now bauxite is abundantly available. Please keep in mind, try to recollect earth crust we have discussed. The upper part of earth crust is called as Sial, S-I-A-L. As a result, we have abundant aluminium. But the separation of bauxite is a bit costlier process. Say bauxite is there, that is usually I want in form of a compound that is called as Al2O3. This compound is called as alumina. So if you are aware of silica, this is element silicon. Whereas if oxygen is combined there, it is called as silica. We discussed this part in particularly different layers of earth we discussed. At that time we discussed this. So this is called as silica, whereas this is called as alumina. So first part, that I want to separate out alumina from aluminium, from bauxite ore. So in the purification process, that is called as Byers process, and then we have to isolate aluminium, that is by electro refining process or electrolytic process. So in that process, aluminium is separated out, which is very high energy consuming process, and therefore the nations or countries which are rich in energy sources, they can use or they can produce aluminium in greater extent. And that's why, in spite of alumina is located everywhere in the world, few countries are there in production. The chief producer, say I'm using word here chief producer and not only producer. So chief producers are that is China, Russia, Canada, USA, Australia and Brazil. These nations are considered as chief producers of this. Now we are moving to next important mineral. So first mineral we discussed, that is bauxite, the source of aluminium. The second mineral I am discussing here, that is not actually we are using as mineral, that is coal. Now coal is having application as number one, that is energy source, conventional energy source. And second important, it can be used for reduction processes in metallurgy. Say in purification or in extraction of iron, we are heating out ore with carbon. So that is called as reduction process. So various applications of coal, they are present. Even try to recollect during Second World War or before Second World War, the scientists invented the process of conversion of coal into petrol. This is synthetic petrol, we are calling that as gasoline. And Krupp, the German industrialist, he is supposed there that to produce large amount of coal, they converted it into gasoline. Now, obviously, the coal is important thing, important energy mineral. If you are concentrating on history part, you will get that why there was industrial revolution in England. Out of that, one important reason, that is not only reason, but important reason, that Britain was having sources of coal. and iron also. But important reason is scientists were there. That is the most important, but they are saying. Anyway, so coal. Well, different varieties of coal are available. I am not able to recollect all, but I do recollect two things. The coal with highest carbon and coal with lowest carbon. The highest carbon coal, that is we are calling anthracite. I am revising the name. Anthracite is the variety having highest amount of coal, and lowest amount is found in pit. Two names we have to remember, anthracite and pit. Now I am going into book. So anthracite, that is containing about 95% carbon, whereas pit contains 35% passing marks. So 35% carbon, that is present in pit. Anthracite contains 95% carbon. Now bituminous is another variety having 40% carbon. That can be have 40 to 80% carbon. Now, bituminous is most widely occurring type of coal in the world. So, neither anthracite nor pit, bituminous, that is 40 to 80%. Then, another name of coal, that is lignite. Now, apart from that, say Germany, they are having majority lignite. Now leading producers of coal in the world, they are China, USA, Australia, India, Russian Federation. So they are large producers. Now leading producers of lignite, they are Germany, Russian Federation and USA. Now chief export, they are Czech Republic and Russian Federation, whereas chief importer, Japan. I am revising. There are different varieties of coal, anthracite and pit, you have to keep in mind, whereas wide variety, that is bituminous. Lignite is also produced, major product of Germany, that is lignite. Now largest production of coal is carried out in China, USA, India, Australia and Russian Federation. That is largest producer. In case of India, if you are having knowledge, the coal is consumed in country also. For example, we have production of iron. For production of iron, tremendous coal is required. Then we have various industries. Basically, they are working on coal, thermal power stations and all. And so, it is not necessary that India is producer means exporter. The exporter countries, they are basically, we discuss the leading exporters of coal, or properly chief exporters of coal, they are Czech Republic, Russian Federation. Where chief exporter, importer, that is Japan. So this way, we are discussing about coal. Now keep in mind, various biological records, they are also obtained from coal mine. For example, fossil records, they are found in coal. Because where we are getting right now coal, these are the places of once upon flourished vegetation. Because of certain action, the land from the forests from surface of earth get underground, and due to incomplete combustion, say inside the earth there is rising temperature, tremendous heat is there, whereas lack of oxygen, so this is called as incomplete combustion, that lead, that substances are converted into coal. And that's why the important part we have to consider, that is the carbon, because carbon combines with oxygen to give carbon dioxide, and this reaction is highly exothermic, and that's why coal is used as nice fuel. After coal, I have to discuss about diamond, because chemically diamond is also carbon and coal is also carbon, but we discuss anthracite is having 95% carbon, whereas diamond is having 100% carbon. We don't know how exactly diamonds are produced, but we believe that under very high pressure and very high temperature, the diamonds are produced. In case of diamond, two important properties are there. Its high refractive index, and therefore light turn inside only, and therefore diamond appear bright. This is because total internal refraction. Second thing, that diamond is very hard. Naturally occurring hardest substance is diamond. But apart from that, people are using diamond as an ornament, or it is symbol of wealth, or somebody may say that those who are believing in astrology, they may say this is some good fruits are there, or like that, for that purpose, I don't know. But it is sure that diamond is obtained from carbon. Till today, we are not able to make artificial diamond. Actually, chemically, carbon and diamond is same. Can we convert carbon or coal available into diamond? But till today, answer is no. Scientists carried out various efforts, and in that, they are able to successfully to produce diamond, but which is not having transparency. This is having black color. So possessing hardness property of diamond, but not light properties. And therefore, these diamonds are not of that use. So for different machines, these diamonds are useful, that is synthetic or artificial diamond or black diamond. Now here, we are saying that diamond, it is naturally obtaining only. Usually, if we believe the concept that Earth is made up of 10 stars, then we'll get the source of diamond. Because the first stage of star, hydrogen is converted into helium. In second stage of star, helium is converted into carbon. Under high temperature and pressure, carbon can be converted into diamond. And that's why we may get here that diamonds formation, but it is very, very rare and therefore costly. Utility wise, not that utility. Hardness, no doubt, that is important. This is non-metallic precious stone. Then maximum production of this diamond, production or say pound, occurrence, that is there in South Africa, then Republic of Congo and Australia. So these are important sources of diamond in the world. Now, after diamond, I will go to royal metal, noble metal, that is gold. From eras, the scientists, Indians, and people around the world were astonished by this gold. They are having tremendous attraction for gold. Important thing, its nice color, shining surface, and comparatively non-reactive nature attracts this metal. It is considered a symbol of wealth, and according to certain ancient alien concepts, they are saying that aliens must have visited Earth in past for the search of gold, we don't know the use of gold properly. They must have knowledge of gold. But at present, gold is widely used for ornament purpose. Other uses, say in medicine also gold is considered, but that is to very, very less extent. Maximum used as ten investment or ornament. In old days, certain people were not having importance of gold. And at that time they traded gold with salt. Particularly this incident happened in central parts of Africa. Now, at present, the gold mines, they are major or concentrated in South Africa. Now, USA, Australia, China and Canada. These countries are having considerable high amount of gold and they are considering gold producers. Witwatersrand, that is the most important gold mining region of South